Welcome to another case study here. We're looking at one I call a tough solve. The reason why I call it a tough solve is because dentistry is just that. It is a custom problem-solving situation for every patient that comes in. And it's like, how do you put the pieces together with the dental tools that you have in your service pouch to try to figure out maybe the best solve? And patients don't like you. They don't like getting stuck by a needle. They don't like paying for dentistry. They don't like the feel of dentistry. You know, you got a lot of things going against you. So this is a tough solve, especially when the patient's so used to what they were doing, but now this front number 9 is fracturing, and now what do you do when we don't have a lot of great bone right here under the nasal sinus? So let's just quickly look at the treatment assessment information. And that looks like bone density is okay. It's yellow and the bone constriction is yellow, but the facial bone plate is really bad. It's not so good. It's an orange, possibly in red at some points, but I'll give it an orange. And the bone characteristics are okay too. There's a little bit of a defect on the ridge right here. So I'll count that into that. But let's take a look at our edentulous sites first. Let's start with right here. We're going to look at that CT. And this is what it looks like. Not good. In terms of occlusal load, wow. If you try to put an implant there, you're way class 3. So this patient really does not have a very good bite situation. Really could put a load onto that. It's really on this anterior. So they're kind of into the bulldog bite a little bit here when they close. So maybe it won't be too angled. It's hard to say. Let's look at number 8. We're going to go right on top of 8. And now you've got to have more of an angle. So that's how the difference between the bone for your implant on 7, if you did that, would be here. But the other problem if you did something on 7 is you're going to be very top heavy. Just to show you what I'm talking about is I'm going to put an implant in just for the heck of it. And this is a small 3.7 by 8.5. And let's see if it even fits. Okay, so what if we got something like that in there? And you're going to try to get it into the angulation that could work best. But now look how far away that you are. And I'll even correct that a little bit to be more correct where the angle could be. But you're way up here. And your incisal edge is way down here. So that, let's look at how long that would actually be. Let's bring that here. And you would be, your incisal edge would probably be about there. So you're, let's just double check. If we have the canine, yep, that's a lateral to the canine. And then we have the anterior. So that lateral actually might be a hair longer. So you're about 12 millimeters on an 8.5 millimeter length implant. And a small diameter one at that. A little bit aggressive in terms of size of a tooth per implant ratio, in my mind. I would not do that. In this scenario, I would say don't do the implant and do a 3-unit bridge. Actually, it has to be a 4-unit bridge. It looks like this is splinted. Not sure why, but it looks like they splinted it. So you're going to have to redo that and do a single crown there. I don't know why they splinted it, but anyway. Do a 3-unit bridge would work out fine there. So now let's look at number 9 and see if there's something salvageable here. This is a tough situation too. Is this fully fractured? What is going on here? Hard to say. Looks like it is right here. We got missing bone here. Very little bone holding that in. So now, what exactly should you do? Now, if you have a 3-unit bridge, do you go across now this missing site and go all the way here and do a 6-unit bridge? Well, let's look at the site next door, and that's really a poor implant site right there. It's just too knife edge. The facial bone was too thin, and that's all wiped away. So your option here is pretty much using number 8 as a pier abutment and going K9 to K9. If you're inclined to do something even bigger, then you double abut going all the way across here. What I really don't like is that this is one little tooth holding the whole kit and caboodle together. So this is a very, very challenging case. Prosthetically, what do you do? Maybe you go double abut over here and go across on these teeth, or I think you should be okay if you didn't double abut and put it here. But this is where it comes down to experience with the doctors and experience with the load, really looking at the patient, looking at their bite, looking at how it actually can come together for you on this. This is not an implant site, and if you're trying to save this bone with a graft, it's pretty useless. This is already kind of dying back already. You're probably looking at something like that anyway, even if you grafted it, if you try to build it up. You still don't have a very good implant site anyway. So I would scratch that, and I would just tell the patient you're going to have to look at a, if you want a fixed prosthetic, you're going to have to really look into doing some sort of larger bridge piece going across here. Or if this patient's really used to doing a partial denture here, the patient just has a flipper, you would just add the tooth to the flipper and see if the patient gets accustomed to that. That could be fine too, but otherwise you're going to have to use this as a pier abutment and then bring your prosthetic all the way across there and hope that this doesn't get recurrent decay. This patient has a history of dentistry, so I don't know if it was decay or other old fillings or something that caused some of these crowns, but he's also missing these molars down here, which tells me that there's something maybe hygienically the patient has to pay a little more attention to. Pretty straightforward, since we don't have to do implants in this area or any kind of miracle grafts or anything like that. And if you were to kind of challenge yourself, then you'd be doing ridge splits or doing something kind of a little bit more on the sketchy area and try to build up that bone to try to get something better into these laterals and that central. I don't see a position where if you took that out and then you utilize this entire area, you do a block graft, you know, on and on. Those are just miracles that I just don't even entertain. So, but anyway, everybody's got their own skill level. Everybody has their own interest in learning something new. And if the patient's inclined to want to go down that path, so be it. And if you can build that up, that would be fantastic. So, but that concludes this case study. And once again, check out some other cases that we've been doing. We have well over 100 and moving on to hundreds. And look at our live streams. Comment on some of the comments on some of these videos. If not, join us on live stream and join the conversation there. Like us on Facebook and subscribe to us on YouTube. Thanks a lot. Cheers.